Here we're looking at a visualization about drone strikes from Pitch Interactive. As we enter the visualization, we're taken through an author-driven narrative, step by step, with an accompanying drone strike animation. This is the narrow stem of the martini glass. As we click through, the final visualization starts to build. Each element fades in slowly, with annotations about notable events during that period. Notice that up until now, it's been linear, with a single path. We're still on the stem of the martini glass. After the visualization is finished building, we're invited to look into the data more closely. We're now in the wide mouth of the glass, and it's become a viewer-driven narrative instead of an author-driven one. I can mouse over specific data points, and a tooltip appears, allowing me to dig into the data more closely. I can also click on the tabs in the upper left to pivot the data and look at it in other ways. Recent news about drone strikes is included below, keeping the visualization relevant and current. Hopefully, you can see how this particular visualization combines both the author-driven and viewer-driven elements to make a compelling narrative. Let's look at one more. In this example, Periscopic shows us a visualization of the number of gun-related deaths in 2013. It starts with a few victims and projects out the number of years they would have lived without gun violence. It keeps a running tally, and the visualization builds exponentially. Similar to the previous example, there's a clear narrative as we enter the visualization, and then we're invited to apply various filters to this data. For example, I want to look at males that are over 30 in the Southeast. I can either look at their projections here or look at a graph. Also included is two major insights, that the majority of victims are men and boys, and that the young people are a significant portion.